Hey, in this video, I'm going to give you some really simple, quick tips to help you to make the most of the 30 days after convention. This is Tasha Smith. I am the founder of Emerge Sales Training. We help network marketers with their sales, leadership, and recruiting skills. And convention is coming up, and this marks basically Happy New Year in the network marketing industry. And this can be a time of great euphoria and excitement, which can quickly lead to tons of momentum and great growth in your business, or it can lead to overwhelm, or it could just like totally fizzle out. I don't want that to happen to you, so I'm going to give you some quick do's and don'ts that I share with my private clients. I think it might help you. A few don'ts. Number one, do not try to give people that didn't attend convention the same feeling as if they were. It is impossible. It's like, I want you to think about the most epic concert you've ever been to, and then you try to explain your feelings and you just end up with, well, you had to be there. And convention is the same thing. The purpose of convention is to increase your confidence, increase your enthusiasm, increase your purpose and product conviction, and it's really for the people in the room. And I'm going to encourage you not to have that expectation of trying to transfer all of that to someone. You may be able to share some wisdom that you learned that would be helpful for them, but don't set yourself up for that disappointment. Number two, do not try to implement new ideas immediately. So you might be sitting there listening to things and your head might be spinning. You'll talk to people, you'll find out what they're doing, and you're gonna wanna come home right away and implement all these amazing ideas, and that really does not work. First of all, it's when I get to the do section, you'll want to have your schedule planned out. You'll want to make sure that you take care of whatever you take care of personally, which doesn't leave room for new ideas, shiny things. And when we're in a state of euphoria, which is what happens at convention, we make bad decisions. We think we're invincible. We think we can do all the things and everything's a great idea. When we get back home and we go to execute, that euphoria is gone and we've made some commitments and probably overcommitted ourselves. So my recommendation is to take all those ideas that you have, put them in a brain dump, maybe a note on your phone or in your notebook, write them all down, keep them, and then maybe set a task in your planner to review that in 2 or 3 weeks once you have executed based on your enthusiasm and you have a better mind to use for good decisions. The third don't is don't vomit all over people about all the things that happen at convention, including new products. Instead, schedule appointments. Usually what I do is set up an appointment to go over your goals for, you know, like for a team member for after convention. Usually what I do is set up an appointment with my customers to let them know what are the new products that might be able to help them with their health. And maybe these are 15-minute appointments, but it works out better for the people you're communicating with. Those are my don'ts. Now, if we stopped there, that would be enough. I want to make sure I give you things that to replace them. So a couple of do's. Do block out before you leave for convention the whole month after convention, including when do you plan on doing your appointments, when do you plan on doing your coaching calls with your team, when do you plan whatever events you want to do. And I also want to make sure you plan in specific outings with your family so you have something to look forward to and you don't get caught in tons of guilt. Number two, call ahead to wherever you're staying at convention and tell them you have specific food, dietary needs, and ask them to put a fridge in your room. They'll do it as if you are breastfeeding, and then you can stop at the grocery store and get a bunch of healthy snacks, and that will help you to just do better when you're at convention because you won't just be eating really, really bad food the whole time. Number three, change your thoughts. If you are one of those people who's like, oh my gosh, I'm going to convention, it's so chaotic, it's so busy, it's so crazy, your behaviors are going to match that line of thought. I want you to shift that to, this is the harvest, this is exciting, it's going to be a lot of work, and every single minute is worth it. That will help. Number four, do break down big yearly goals into the number of people you need to meet with each week. There's usually this pinnacle rank in each company where that's the one everyone's like fired up about. Like that's when you've arrived. And after convention, you'll likely have that as your goal. But you can't hit that goal until you break it all the way down into how many people do I need to meet with on a weekly basis in order to get there. So make sure that you take the time to break that down. And the fifth is, if you have big goals, make sure you get help. This is a shameless, I guess, little plug for our coaching programs, where one of the things that we do really well in our one-on-one coaching and our group coaching is help you with the mastery and the execution and the skills in order to reach those big goals of yours. And if you have a really big goal, you probably need to increase some skills, or you need to have a really good plan that's broken down into small benchmarks so that you're able to actually achieve it, bite-sized chunks. And you may need some help to do that. And we have coached tons of people on reaching their goals, and we can help or make sure that you partner up with some people who have expertise in this area if it isn't us. So let me just do a quick recap. Don't try to give everyone the feelings as if they were there. Don't try to implement all your new ideas immediately. Don't vomit on people. Offer appointments instead. Dues, block out 1 month after the convention, including dates with your family. Number two, call ahead and get a fridge. Number three, change your thoughts from "I'm overwhelmed" to "this is exciting." Number four, break down yearly goals in all the way down to weekly activities. And number five, get help with your big goals. And those are my tips for you today. I hope this was helpful for you, and enjoy your convention. And I can't wait till you get back and we can get to work. All right, bye.